Good morning, children.
Sir.
So, let's continue with the chapter number 3, ruling the countryside with history. Fine. In the last class of history, I gave you a brief intro of what is going to be taught in this chapter. Fine, children. I don't know how many of you are watching the video properly, but children, kindly watch the videos properly. It is not a request, it is not an order either. It's just because when you are going to give examinations, at that time this explanation which is actually given in the videos is going to help you. At that time you will not fall short of explanation. Children, kindly do not play with your future. Please watch the videos regularly, properly, and keep doing your work in a proper manner. Okay, getting back to the chapter. The company became Diwan. Now, what happens with the Diwani? What is Diwani? After the assumption of Diwani in 1765, the company, now what is company? The East India Company, began to use vast revenue resources of Bengal. Now, how did we, as we were engaged with the history chapter 2, trade to territory, before the summer vacation, so it's a long duration and hope you must have forgotten, but still I'll give you a quick review. Bengal Nawab, then Sirajuddola, Battle of Palasi, Battle of Paksar, and then subsidiary alliance, all these terms forcing us to review and to sum up a particular conclusion. Now, what was the conclusion? That the moment the Nawab of Bengal was defeated, Sirajuddola was defeated, and West Bengal was captured by the East India Company Britishers, when this particular territory called as West Bengal was taken up, was actually taken up by the Britishers. At that time, what happened? This tendency, the mental tendency of the Britishers, posed a particular threat to the individuality of the Indian people in West Bengal as well as all over the country. Now, the question mark was, which actually posed threat to West Bengal, was not for only the Indian people, it was for the Nawabs of Bengal as well as the Nawabs throughout the India. The ruling pattern, the king pattern of India was actually, the ruling pattern of the country was going to change. Now, how and what were the consequences which molded or actually transformed the ruling pattern into a different manner? The company began to use the vast revenue resources of Bengal. This caused a huge loss of revenue for Bengal. The Bengal economy fell into deep crisis. Now, what happened? What revenue, what sources of Bengal was taken by the Britishers? First, the artisans. They began to desert villages because they were being forced to sell their goods to the company at low prices. Agricultural cultivation showed signs of collapse. Then in 1770, a terrible famine killed 10 million people in Bengal. The company felt the need of improvement in the field of agriculture. Now, before the exports and imports, then the artist, the art was actually, you can say, bargained by the East India Company traders. And after that, the last thing was the cultivation as well as the agriculture, which was also snatched off by the farmers. Now, how it was snatched by the farmers, let's see. Finally, the company introduced permanent settlement in 1793. See, the famine which hit Bengal was 1770. Naturally, a place which has no money, no food, no shelter for the people to reside in and to continue in. Can you imagine, children, can you just imagine a survival, a life of survival over there? It was highly impossible for anyone to survive over such situations. Now, after this, in 1793, now this permanent settlement was introduced. As I gave the definition of permanent settlement, that was no tariffs to be increased or imposed in permanent settlement, it was fixed. So now let's understand actually what is permanent settlement, apart from what was the definition. The Rajas and the Talukdars were asked to collect rent from the peasants and pay revenue to the company. It was felt that this would ensure a regular flow of revenue into company's treasury and at the same time encourage the zamindars to invest in improving the land. Now, this land, a piece of land which was owned by the farmers or the zamindars, this was actually, you can say, illegally or unwantedly, or you can say forcibly acquired by these British people. Now, what they did, they imposed a certain tax that as this land is yours, you have to pay a particular rent regularly, and this is your duty to pay a tax or rent. Despite of the fact whether that land belonged to that person or not. Now, this rent, these Britishers imposed such a rent in order to collect revenue, in order to create a cash inflow statement. Fine, they wanted to create an inflow of money. But children, how will a poor person pay who does not have a single penny even to lit fire in his home? So the condition was so poor, but still, despite of such poor conditions, the village farmers actually had to compensate, and somehow they had to pay the rent. Now, by the first decade of the 19th century, the prices in the market rose and civilization slowly expanded. Now, the permanent settlement was oppressive for the cultivators. The rent they paid to the zamindars was high, and their right on the land was insecure. That is, they were having their own land and they paid the rent to the zamindars, which was highly risky, but nobody actually raised voice against it. Now, after the failure of permanent settlement, Holt McKenzie, an Englishman, devised a new system called the Mehelwari system. I repeat, Holt McKenzie introduced a new system called as the Mehelwari system. Now, what was it? The collectors were asked to visit villages, inspect the land, measure the fields, record the customs and rights of different groups. Now, this person introduced a new law that if suppose you have 5 acres of land, it was to be measured by the people, the collectors. They'll be measured, they would come to you, they'll measure your land, they will measure your fields, record the customs, the output, the yield that will be coming from your fields and go off. Now this again created a problem, or you can say a particular scene of this particular scene scenario of agitation. The Rayot Vari, apart from that, one more new system was introduced. The Rayot Vari settlement was made directly by the cultivators. It was initiated by Captain Alexander Red. Alexander Red and developed by Thomas Munro. The system was gradually extended all over the South India. Now, all the new systems proved to be a failure. The company had imposed these systems in order to increase the income from land, but its purpose was not solved because the revenue demand was very high. By the late 18th century, what happened, the company was trying to expand the cultivation of opium and indigo. Indian indigo was in great demand in Europe. Hence, the company in India looked for ways to expand the area under indigo cultivation. As indigo trade, children listen carefully, as indigo trade grew, commercial agents and officials of the company began investing in the indigo production. Now, this indigo was a curse for the Indian farmers. This indigo was such a plant. Basically, what was indigo? Indigo was just a dye. It was a plant, you can say, which produced blue ink or blue color. Fine. Now, this plant was such a, indigo as well as opium, these two plants were such poisonous plants. If once they were cultivated or grown on a field, the field went barren. That is, the field could not be used or reused for any kind of cultivation purposes. Now, the Britishers, the British people, the British officials wanted the Indian farmers to cultivate indigo. They wanted a good harvest of indigo. Now, this cultivation, this particular harvesting of indigo resulted into tremendous hazardous effects. As a result, this particular cultivation of indigo was reduced and finally it was stopped and culminated. But in the long run, it harmed to the people and it could not prove to be a successful plan which the British officials thought of implementing in Indian fields. So children, what did you learn from this today? You can please write a question. I'm giving you a question that what was indigo cultivation and how did it affect the lives of the people? You can write this answer, this question as well as this answer in your fair notebooks. Thank you. Have a nice day ahead. Keep learning, keep reading, and don't waste your time in heavy games. Sairam children, thank you for today.